Friends, this is Stelios Demiras again from Mr. Black Publications, and a very, very different thing today. After a long time, I decided to play with 176 scale, something that I had in my stash for years, with the Vickers light tank MK6. Versions ABC from Airfix. Of course, it's not moldings from Airfix, probably from IBG, I don't know exactly, but this is not something that it's important. The quality is very good, as you can see, and I will tell you. The only thing that I was very frustrated and disappointed, it was the instruction sheet. Believe me, it was very, very difficult to follow it. And I'm a professional modeler, I can say. A lot of things that you don't know where to glue it. You must have absolutely necessary something with like 3D designs or blueprints, I can say. Otherwise, you cannot have a decent model. It's very strange for Airfix, and also I'm very disappointed because they have it in skill 1 for newcomers. It's not for newcomers. It's not for newcomers. It's very difficult to have to construct it to a decent model. The instruction sheet need a lot of improvements. It's not easy to follow it. Anyway, I went to my library and found a very good book from George Bradford. That has these drawings, so I hadn't a clue what to do. Otherwise, only if you base only in this instruction sheet, you will be disappointed, unfortunately. Anyway, I managed to make a decent model, and of course, you can add a lot of details, but for me it was something for fun. I made some improvements. I just make holes in the barrels and in the smoke grenade launcher and in the exhaust, so to have more decent appearance. I use this one. This is from child vaccine. It's very, very small needle, and it's very good to open holes in these tiny parts. You can see the holes, I hope, here, you see, and the smoke grenade launchers and the exhaust. Anyway, the tracks are very good because it's plastic. I just put it with a little glue just for the presentation. I will dismount it afterwards because it's better to paint it afterwards because you cannot put the brass here. So the fit was pretty good. The fit was pretty good. It's a nice little model. It's a nice little model, and I joined, but I was a little frustrated with the instructions sheet. It's not for newcomers. It's not for skill 1. You don't know where to glue. Also, some parts here are not clearly where to glue it or to leave it, because probably they put all the versions in one kit, and it's a little difficult to understand where to put and what to leave out and what to use. So you must, if you like this kit, this model, okay, you can have it, but you must absolutely, you have to find a small reference for some parts, because also the photos in the internet are not so explanatory. For most of the kit, I use the thicker plastic cement from AK, and for the small parts, the thinner. We have this for three different versions. I use some plastic art from AK to add a small port here, because it's not given. And my tools were the X-Acto, not very sharp point, I don't use because it's dangerous. Some files, not only metal, some files, also you can find in the AK website. Some tweezer for small parts, and I have done also something. You see here, I glue it in the end, some paper, so you don't throw away the parts. Some paper from Tamiya, and for bigger drills, for bigger holes, this for the small to start it, because it's difficult to start it the hole. It's better to use this one, because it's really sharp and very, very small. It's very helpful. So the kit, it's nice. It's I like it. I had to play with 176 scale for years, and this also different part. Just be careful with the instruction sheet. It's not necessary to put all this. I put it just to be more, and also I had something missing here, broken. I put it from scratch, but the quality of detail for this such a kit, it's very good. It's not old Airfix kit, it's probably a reboxing from other company, but you need something better for instructions. Have a nice day.